Well, I think that everybody's just kind of catching their breath. I know I am. Literally, last two videos, I pointed out that, you know, some of the figures and political figures and people of influence in the world and how they may be linked into the cosmic corporate culture. And it seems as though I went a little bit too far. And when I was saying this, especially about the President of the United States, I suddenly felt something like hit my throat, like my throat's gonna be cut or something. It's like, whoa, you know. It's like there's some sort of psychic defense barrier there. You're not supposed to say stuff like that. And then my breathing began to be affected, and I got all, my breathing does not normal, and my tension got bad, and then I came down with a very bad cold. And then from there, I began coughing in terrible ways, like my breathing was being definitely pulsed and affected, and they're trying to disrupt my breathing. Who's they? I don't know, but I would say there's some sort of psychic defense shield to deflect any criticism or any mention of these topics. And I was just sort of doing it in passing. It's really not my thing at all, actually. But that just shows you how severely guarded the situation is. So this morning I had to begin to work to deflect that and send these gifts back to the ones that were sending it to me. And I decided I'm not going to cough anymore, and I haven't coughed since. Before, I was uncontrollably coughing in very strange ways. I said, wow, this is really odd. I've never experienced this before. And my whole system was being shaken by this very odd type of hacking and coughing. And so I decided, no more coughing, that's it. Drawn the line, I haven't coughed since. And I've started to send this back to whoever, whatever it is that is sending this to me. I say, thank you very much, but not right now. Maybe a little bit later, but not now. Don't have time for this right now. So I started using my spiritual will. Before, it was getting worse and worse. I couldn't fend it off. So if you wonder, how do these people manage? They're protected through psychics, through some sort of field that anybody who tries to bring out the truth or about what they're doing end up feeling sick, getting sick, really, and falling apart. And of course, they do this at a distance using their mind, it's like that. So, experiencing this firsthand, it's not a joke. It is not a joke. I realized I'd gone too far. As soon as that, my throat, you know, it's like, wow. And I was unable to stop it. I got very nervous. So you're not supposed to say this stuff. Okay, but listen, we'll say whatever we want to say. Not to, you know, target anybody. We're not targeting anyone. We're just using our free speech here. And we have every right to do so. We will continue to do so. But that's not really our thing. So as far as, you know, there's this, we're in the tribulation period, most likely. Most likely it started December 21st, 2012. We'll end December 28th, 2019, supposedly. This is probably pretty good, pretty accurate. And we're reaching the three and a half year period, midway point in, starting July 1st. That will be have reached the halfway. And that's when I said we must be confirmed in our clarity by that time, the halfway point, because after then it starts going collapsing into compliance very seriously. So it's a bigger picture than any one person. It's ridiculous for anyone to get all snooty about the fact we happen to mention somebody happens to be in a... It's all a dream anyway. It's all a silly dream anyway. So it just happens if somebody's in a position, a high position, they're going to get mentioned. That comes with the territory. There's nothing... we're not trying to vilify anybody because this is all a dream. Why vilify anybody in a dream? It's ridiculous. But we're just sort of pointing out... the dynamic here, actually, in reality has no dynamics, but dreams do. Most certainly, dreams have all sorts of dynamics, and everybody is all uptight, you know, and talking about all this stuff. And you know, you talk about the ETs and the Anunnaki, and you know, they all take themselves so seriously. The remedy remedy is, don't take any of this seriously. Don't take it seriously. Don't take it, this dream, seriously. There's nothing serious in this dream. There are no consequences of this dream to what we are. None. No consequences. So why do we take it seriously? So this is the ultimate remedy. The ultimate remedy, Jesus says, is to laugh at the whole situation and don't take it serious. What keeps us asleep in this dream is taking it seriously. This is what keeps us asleep. Because we say, I can't wake up. I can't wake up. You know, there's dynamics at play here. I gotta find out what happens. This is what keeps us asleep, plain and simple. So, by not taking the dream seriously, that's how you awaken from it. That is the key. Yeah. And of course, in a dream, you can dream up all sorts of dynamics of consequences, all these consequences, but they're just dream consequences. They don't affect our functionality at all. Functionality of spirit is not being affected by anything whatsoever. No dynamics affect our functionality as spirit, which is perfect freedom. Perfect freedom cannot be affected by anything. Okay, there are no dynamics in perfect freedom. That is the dynamic. We can choose any experience we want this moment. We can choose the next moment to keep it the same, or we can choose to change it. We're not bound to keep it the same, and we're not bound to change it. Plain and simple. God is not the architect of universes, not the grand architect of you know, not the designer, some grand designer of purpose and plan, and not some galactic center that is impulsing this planet and changing our DNA and our chakra system and all this. That's all a dream. That's all a dream. This is the dream we're dreaming. Now, we dream on a big scale. Absolutely we do. And we have put in all this stuff in a dream. Spirit, when spirit dreams, it dreams colossally large scale. Of course, there's spirit knows no limits whatsoever, so there's no limits to what it can dream. But that's not God at all. God is not working through dynamics in our lives like that. Not at all. Now, Jesus said that we're the Son of God, Son of God, but he used this term. He said S-U-N. Think of yourself as S-U-N, a sun. What does a sun do? A sun like radiates radiation in all directions, just, you know, more or less constantly, right? It's a 360 degree outflowing radiance, right? It's the idea of this 360 degree radiance in all directions. And he says what we are is we radiate joy, gratitude, happiness, you know, well, happiness is joy, peace, joy, gratitude. We radiate this like a sun radiates energy, electromagnetic energy, whatever it's radiating. We radiate joy in all directions. So we are sons of God, S-U-N-S, sons of God, meaning we are these radiant spheres, almost you could say, radiant spheres of this joy. And this is how I experienced my true self a few months back, is as this radiant, so sphere-like feeling, presence that was radiating this joy and gratitude and in all directions, constantly. Not being affected by its environment or any dynamics. No dynamics were affecting it at all. This is my experience. This is my testimony. So I agree to what Jesus said. We are sons of God. Absolutely we are. And this is within everyone. So the only trouble that anybody has, including the president, the pope, and you name it, whatever, the Anunnaki, and all the other ETs, and the Masons, and the Illuminati, and going cosmic corporate culture, on and on and on and on. The only problem they have is that taking it seriously. All this, they're taking it too seriously. Because they have the joy within them too. They are sons of God also. And it's just that they are forgetting to laugh at the silliness of trying to sell death to God, sell life and death to God. Which is this all of this universe is just a marketing campaign, trying to market something to God. Saying, look at this we have for you, God. They just have forgotten to laugh. They've taken it too seriously. That's the only problem anyone has. They've taken it too seriously, and thus they're still asleep, thinking that they have to overcome these consequences and protect themselves from all these dream dynamics. So that's the spirit in which I see it. Not condemning anyone at all, because they all are equal sons of God. They're just taking it too seriously. So we need to, you know, hey, I got to send this, you know, sickness interfering with my breathing back to them and say, look, thanks for thinking of me. But not right now, maybe later, but not right now. And got to remember, laugh. You know, send it back with some laughter. Thank you, love and laughter, joy, love, laughter. Yeah, so it's been a real drag since doing those videos. I was thinking, I shouldn't have done those videos. I think I maybe taking them down, you know, and just getting them off there. We'll see if this continues, if I cannot get this, you know, sent back. Return to sender, no addressee here by that name. I might take them down, because I guess somebody's really in a snit about it, taking it too seriously. Don't take yourself too seriously. The only self we are is this radiant, sun-like presence of joy, love, gratitude, that's perfectly free and knows nothing other than that. So, the ones that liberate from the dream, is awakened, are the ones who have this joy, who have this, don't take it seriously at all. It's like there's the radiant laughter, radiant joy, just like, you know, nothing is wrong, there's no dynamics. And by helping us not take it seriously, we awaken from the dream too. This is the key. You see the sages, the saviors, the gurus, the real top-notch ones, that, you can tell that they're not taking this world seriously at all. It's a joke. It's just it's a hilarious joke. Nothing's like a dream. It's a dream content. Nothing to take seriously here. We're completely in control of the dream, actually. Everything that's happening, we're trying to market death, life and death to God. It's very key that we realize that the marketing of life and death to God is the dream. That is the dream. And again, marketing life to God is saying that we are bound to keep the same experience here. Marketing death to God saying that we're bound to choose a new experience, and we must, you know, force change. The others force non-change. And neither are true. Neither are true. Hummingbird here is going at this palm tree. It's a plastic palm tree, and the hummingbird is trying to go in, trying to get nectar from it. There's no nectar there. It's a plastic palm tree. Yeah, maybe I'll bring that palm tree over here. It's an emerald green hummingbird. Yeah, it was funny. I thought I saw something in there. He's opening its beak, trying to get something. There's nothing there. It's plastic. I haven't had a cold in a long, long, long time. So it's very unusual. This is in. Let's see if I can get my breathing back to, you know, normal, free it from this fear. Some really nasty tension there for sure. And this highlights a dream I had long ago about this very situation of the 44th president. When oil was dropping, dropping, I would say something and it would enrage the powers that be, the princes of the air, so to speak, which is cosmic corporate culture. It would enrage cosmic corporate culture, and they would track me down and put a gun on me, so to speak, and try to cause kill me with fear. And the dream, I was able to finally stand up to him and say, no, you're not going to do that. You're not going to do that. And it was the 44th president of the United States holding the butt behind. And then he backed down and said, okay. Because he's not really the will behind it. He's just a front man actor sort of type. But then I saw behind him, I saw the ones who were really the radicals. I call them the radical feminists, are the ones who are very much pushing the agenda, present agenda here, to push cosmic corporate culture on the planet. And it could have been also males too, you know, the radical communist, radical, that type, radical feminism, radical communism, saying, you know, we have to make this world basically safe for hybrids, which is what they're doing, and they plan on replacing human beings with hybrids. All this stuff has been going on for a long time, and they feel human beings are, you know, ruining the planet, and they need to have some more responsible citizens here. And so they're very ferocious about it. But keep in mind, this world is not our home at all. I remember I was just listening to one YouTube video, and someone saying that this whole ascension thing is a scam. Well, it both is and it isn't. It depends who's talking about it. You know, there is a lot of scams about being lifted off of ships and stuff. Okay, that there is a lot of scams and lies about that. But then he said, you know, who in the world would want to leave here anyway? It's ridiculous. This is our home. Planet Earth's our home. No, we love it here. Nobody would want to leave here. I said, what? This garbage dump. I mean, this place is horrible. So, certainly. And then he said, there's no place else anyway. There isn't any place else to live. No planets we could live on anyway. Really? Really? There's probably millions upon millions upon millions of planets throughout the cosmos. And maybe even almost uncountable. That after all this blue that we see in the sky, that's just oxygen. Because that's reflecting it. It gives a blue tint as the sun goes through. It blocks the other colors a little bit and allows the blue to come through. It's a sign that the planet has oxygen on it. Now, there's many planets in the cosmos that have oxygen on it, right? That have a breathable atmosphere. So how can you say there's no place else in the whole universe? No place else in the dream, you know, where anyone could go. That's pretty ridiculous. The idea that this is the only place, this is it, you know, is highly questionable. Especially Jesus could manifest such a planet for us instantly, actually. Can manifest a whole realm instantly. Holy Spirit can do this also. So it's kind of an absurd statement. So it's not absurd to think that we could go somewhere else. That is possible. If they don't want us here, you know, they don't want us here. They want hybrids to take over the planet, and okay, good luck with that. Whatever. And it's fine. It's part of the dream. I've seen the future of this planet, and indeed, there are all these hybrids that came here, mixtures of human and other races, and they worked on terraforming the planet, turned it into kind of a resort-like place, and that's fine. But we're not bodies. We're spirit. We're these sons of God. This is what we are. It has nothing to do with the body. Nothing whatsoever. It's the idea that, you know, you're saying like, you know, in the future it's going to be like the paradise here. Unbelievably great. You'd be able to teleport yourself anywhere. You want to go somewhere. You just think yourself there and you can go there. Well, whoopee, you know. People right now, you can get on an airplane and go somewhere. I remember Buddha said someone like walked across the water to get to him, a stream, a river or something. And he had to do a lot of practice and prayers and, you know, meditate and focus. And he finally walked across it. And Buddha said, why didn't you just give the ferryman, you know, like a penny or two, and he would have taken you across. He said, no problem. He says, don't make these cities, these spiritual abilities, don't make those your goal. That's not the goal. It's not the goal to teleport yourself somewhere. Teleport the body somewhere. It's the goal's awakened from the dream. That's the goal. Awakened from the dream. The dream of conditions, the dream of situations, the dream of time and space, the dream of process, the dream of form, the dream of dynamics. This is what we need to wake up from. And we only wake up from it when we don't take any of it seriously anymore. Has there ever been any real death take place? No, everything's just an appearance. It's just light. Has the light died? When an appearance dies, does the light die? The light that was appearing, what does it do? It just reconfigures in some other way. There hasn't been any loss of light. The plasticity of light doesn't disappear. So the idea that we need to embody spirit, and that's our goal here in form, is not true. Jesus doesn't say, he sees the opposite. He said, this is delusion. What you are can never be embodied. It's absolutely impossible. You're perfectly free at any moment to have any experience that there could ever be. You can be a universe. You can be a non-universe. He says it's beyond what we can even imagine. So it has nothing to do with trying to embody into some human form. Human, you know, we're not human beings at all. We're spirit. And this is something that I noticed the world has a very tough time with, because most of the New Agers are all talking about the body, integrating body and spirit and all this kind of nonsense. That's all a dream. That's all a dream. We can say, I've never been a body, I've always been free. I am the Son of God, and that feels sweet to me. I've never been a body, I've always been free. I am the Son of God. I am a Son of God. Say, I am a Son of God. I am a Son of God. And that feels very sweet to me. So I've been using a lot of focus to fend off this malady that suddenly struck me. In other videos, you can see me after a really powerful video, suddenly something. I feel my throat like being struck real strong, and I had to like fight it off, and I fought it off, and everything was okay. But this time, I wasn't able to fight it off. I guess I was too intimidated. There's something about the bigwigs, you know, that intimidates us. We're taught to bow to them, you know, and say, okay, we'll make an exception there. And then no exceptions, no exceptions. I've never been a body, I've always been free. I am a Son of God. And that feels real sweet to me. I've never been a body, I've always been free. I am the Son of God, and that's all there is to see. That's all there is to see. I've never been a body, I've always been free. I am the Son of God, and that's all there is to see. That's all there is to see. That's all there is to see. I've never been a body, I've always been free. I am a Son of God, and that's all there is to see. That is me. That is the me. I've never been a body, always been free. I am a Son of God, and that is what I see. That is what I see. I see it. So everyone has the right to see it. Everyone has the equal right to see the truth of what they are. So I support everybody's right, including the fearful ones who have taken it too seriously and forgotten to laugh. It includes them just as much as it includes everybody else. So I say, hey, lighten up, everyone here. You know, let's not let's not throw the baby out with the bathwater. I am a son of God. I have always been free. I am perfectly complete, and this is what I see. This is what I see. I am a son of God. I have always been free. I am perfectly complete, and this is what I see. But I think I'm going to get off of the, you know, talking about the Illuminati and the ET, blah, 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 because that doesn't wake us up. What it really does, it makes us take things too seriously. Think, oh, wow, yeah, all these dynamics are going on. So the reason for this YouTube channel is to bring us away from that seriousness and get us into lighten us up. This is what saves us. This is what awakens us from the dream. Now, in the dream, there are all this stuff going on that if you take the dream as real, then it seems very serious indeed. Extremely so. There's no question about it. Remember, our goal here is to wake up from the dream, which we can only do by not taking it seriously. It at its very root. So it's not like you say, well, okay, first I have to solve this serious problem I have. You know, I have a serious problem. You need to solve it. And then I won't take the dream seriously. No, that's taking the dream seriously. That is taking the dream seriously. Insisting on solutions within the dream means you feel there's consequences. You take it seriously. That only binds you to sleeping. So you take none of it as serious. There is nothing serious in this dream. Nothing consequential. I am a son of God. I am perfectly free. I am totally complete. And this is all that I see. This comprises all that I see. This comprises all that I see. I see this. Jesus says that once we get to a certain point, we will literally see the truth. We will literally see the truth. This is what awakening from the dream means. We see the truth. And people in the dream say, I will wake up too. But it's too serious for me. So if you can just fix my problems for me. No, that just makes it worse. Because then someone says, hey, this dream isn't so bad. I mean, I can succeed in this dream. You know, I'm just having trouble selling this to God. You know, selling this dream to God, dream of life and death. I have a lot of problems, but if someone can solve my problems, I'll be able to market it better then. You know, this is the way that they think. And plus, it will make them think like, oh, you take it seriously. You know, you must take that seriously too. Okay, so it is serious. So you cannot really function that way. And people say, I'm under psychic attack or something. Well, you know, all that stuff happens. All this stuff happens to, but you have to use your will. Don't ask for someone else's will. So you have to do it. Ask for God to inspire your will. Okay, your will. You are a son of God. You have the will to say, I don't want this right now. I don't choose this right now. Maybe a little bit later. It's possible, but not right now. Thanks, but no thanks. So what I'm doing is giving people the tools, reminding what are the tools we have when we engage our will. You cannot, you know, awaken without engaging your will to awaken and realize, hey, this isn't to be taken seriously. There are no consequences whatsoever to what I am. I cannot be harmed. I'm invulnerable. I am complete. I'm invulnerable. I am complete. I am the Son of God. In me there is no defeat. Benefit of this malady is not eating so much. I sort of lose some weight. That's good. Silver lining, right? So respond to the situation with love, with spiritual confidence, with spiritual will, which is love, which is freedom. So how you succeed in awakening from the dream is recognizing your freedom and laughing at the silliness that somehow you're bound to anything, either to life or death. Reality is eternal. Eternal isness. Reality is eternal isness. Eternal isness is reality. It's not life and it's not death. We dreamed up a dream of life and death, good and bad, life and death. We're the ones who did that, just to see if we could define reality and then say that we're greater than God. But it's just a dream, no consequence whatsoever. And you have to, again, use your spiritual will. It's easy on the level of the ego to confound this. In fact, the ego will confound it for you every time. And you just have to say, no, not right, not now. Okay, as far as being, no whatabouts right now. Maybe later on, whatabouts, but right now, no. Jesus says this joy is the Son of God. Joy is within us all the time, and we can let it flow and reach surface consciousness that we've been trying to overlay it and ignore it. And we get little whispers, little sparkles, little whispers of it, which is true. I have had that. So it's an interesting question of what do? You try to battle against these nefarious, cosmic corporate culture and its nefarious designs? Or do you try to laugh and wake up from the dream? It seems to me that the real teachers support laughing and waking up from the dream. They don't get into all this, nefarious goings on, which are extremely nefarious. It's almost interesting that it's so nefarious, right? It really is. It's like it's easy to get pulled into it and say, wow. Now, pole shift, have there been pole shifts in the past? It seems very likely that the scientific evidence is quite strong in many, many ways. Will there be another one coming? Quite likely, given the magnetic pole wandering. This is a serious thing, fine. But again, that doesn't help us wake up from the dream. We're not bodies. We don't live in a world. These things have no consequence to us whatsoever. This is part of a dream. Oh, that's just part of a dream. So it really doesn't help us much to really dig into that. I used to do, but it didn't help awaken me. It just brings about fear and concern. Well, what do we do about it? How do we survive this and everything? Well, if you realize this is all just a dream, I'm sure you're going to survive anything. You'll survive just fine. I don't know about the body. But certainly, as far as transportation, you can take the body anywhere if you want to. Sure. It's funny that this people say, the world's going to be an incredible place. You'll be able to think wherever you want to go, and you'll be able to go there like that and get some food. You see some food somewhere, and you'll be able to take yourself to the mountaintop, and it's like unbelievable paradise. Well, if that's the case, if you can teleport your body wherever you want to, why can't you teleport it anywhere in the universe? Why should you be bound to this planet? See? I didn't think of... or teleport to any dimension you want to, actually. And who cares about whatever plans but the Anunnaki want us to do something, blah, 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 cosmic corporate culture want. Doesn't matter what they want or think they want. They're all confused anyway. So it really doesn't matter, if they could shift their perspective, they'd see it in a different way. It's just a matter of they're locked into certain perspectives, certain dynamics of the dream that they've not lightened up about yet and taken too seriously. And it's easy to have a turnaround in perspective, where you can just see, hey, I see it differently now. It doesn't interest me anymore. I don't need to do this. So all these needs and plans and blueprints and stuff, none of that's really set in stone. It's that they're just, they're too into the dream. They're too into the marketing campaign. You know, they're believing the importance of the marketing campaign. And they feel that they're essential. You know, the planet Earth is absolutely essential for this marketing campaign to work. And we have to make sure that, you know, this Earth is like a really great place. And so the marketing campaign will work somehow. They're locked into this, gotta sell. It's like a salesperson who just can't stop selling. They're, you know, they're not able to step outside the box and realize there's nothing we need to sell God. God's not a buyer. There's nothing to buy. God created perfect freedom. Within perfect freedom, there is no thing to buy. There is no thingness to buy. Because every so-called thing both is and isn't. Both eternally is and eternally isn't. Because we're free to experience it or not experience it. When we get into trouble, it's thinking that in determinism, thinking that we have to experience this, that God ordained it, that then you lose sight of God, you don't know God. So we need to be aware of God, which is aware of ourselves, our freedom. God is within us. We are all sons of God. Dreaming that we're bodies, or in time-space process form, energetic patterns, that we're energetic patterns of some sort. No, we're not. Energetic patterns are totally flexible. I mean, you can turn it into anything you want. Any energetic pattern can be turned into any other energetic pattern. There's no identity in energetic patterns. What we are doesn't have any energetic pattern, doesn't have any definition. And there is no inside or outside. As far as things, there are no things inside or outside. There's no insideness and no outsideness of pure spaciousness. What is inside? How can you say there's something inside pure spaciousness? Something outside is the inside of a container. Somehow that's inside pure spaciousness, and outside the container is outside pure spaciousness. There's some break in continuity. You see, there's some seam there. There's no seam at all. There's no seam at all. Like, for instance, this container here, you know, is inside plastic container, is inside, and then the plastic and then outside. Is that three different types of spaciousness, pure spaciousness? No, there's only one. The inside, the air inside occupies pure spaciousness, the plastic occupies the same pure spaciousness, and the air outside occupies the same pure spaciousness. So there's no thingness in that, in terms of that at all. For some reason, these realizations, even though they have gotten close, they have not dawned. The dawning has sort of just been, you know, not quite pushed through. I don't know why. It's continuity fear. And the way the world is going, and the intensity of everything, and who knows? Who knows what the variables are? Try not to think about it. You just have to keep practicing. Maybe I just haven't, I don't know, I haven't pushed it, you know, intensely enough. There haven't been any opportunities arise for me whatsoever. So I'm not sure what's going on. So what we need to do is be centered in the continuity problem. Realize the only problem we have, I don't have an Illuminati problem, I have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem that I have. I don't have any other problem whatsoever. The Illuminati problem doesn't exist for me, and therefore has no meaning. It doesn't exist as a problem for me whatsoever, therefore has no meaning. Only the vision of oneness, vision of isness, the vision of oneness, has meaning for me. Only the vision of oneness has meaning for me. okay. We can practice in this way. It was the only problem that I have. It's very severe, yes. But the Pope Francis problem has absolutely no value to me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. The Pope Francis problem is not a problem for me. It doesn't exist as a problem for me. It therefore has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. So you see, we put this in a positive light. We understand what our goal is, waking up from this dream. Don't take it seriously. And insist that these other things are not problems. I don't have a Obama problem. I have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem that I have. The Obama problem doesn't exist as a problem for me. Therefore, it has no value for me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I don't have a cosmic corporate culture problem. I have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem I have. Cosmic culture, cosmic corporate culture problem doesn't exist as a problem for me. It has no existence as a problem, therefore has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I don't have an ET problem, I have a continuity problem. The ET problem doesn't exist, therefore is meaningless to me. Only the vision of oneness has meaning for me. Only the vision of oneness has meaning for me. So, the only problem I have is a continuity problem. Everything else are not problems at all. I have no meaning, therefore I have no meaning, meaningless. I don't need to solve them, you see what I'm saying? Let's say it has absolutely no meaning. There's no reason to try to solve any of it. It's not my problem. I don't have that problem. I do have a continuity problem, and the vision of oneness solves that problem for me. So these are the spiritual tools that we need to be using. For some reason, I've not been able to convey this to the world and get any momentum going. I think people are too caught up in the dynamics of the dream. And the whole thing is we have to detach from it. It's not my problem. I don't have that problem. I don't have a world problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a world problem. I have a continuity problem. Therefore, the world has no meaning to me. Only vision of oneness has meaning to me. The world problem doesn't exist. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Problem at all. I do have a severe continuity problem, but that's the only problem I have. Cosmic problem doesn't exist for me. Therefore, it's meaningless. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. For me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I don't have a crisis problem whatsoever at all. I have a continuity problem. Continuity problem is the only problem I have. Crisis problem has absolutely no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I don't have a sickness problem. I have a continuity problem. Sickness problem doesn't exist for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have an illness problem. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. Illness has no value for me. Now only the vision of oneness has value for me. Super strong sneeze just built up that. And those tend to disrupt your breathing, see? I don't have a breathing problem. I have a continuity problem. Continuity problem is the only problem I have. A breathing problem has no value for me whatsoever. Has zero value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. It's interesting about goals, reaching goals. I had this goal for my weight by reach today, and I was way off just a little while ago. I said, there's no way I'm going to reach it whatsoever. But today I got a pretty good reading, and maybe by tomorrow I may have reached it. It's possible. And maybe you know, by maybe in 2 days, for sure, I think I can reach it. Which, so it's just a little bit late, but, you know, that's okay. So we might think we're far away from reaching our goals, but if we just keep working at it, maybe something will help us somehow. We'll be helped to reach our goal if we just don't give up. And you won't have tomorrow if you give up today. See? So just hold on a little longer. Help is on the way. Spiritual will is on the way. Our will to not take time, space, process, and form seriously is on the way. Now, why there doesn't seem to be momentum between various breakthroughs, I don't know. Maybe it's just a continuity fear. Probably it's hard to take. It's, you have breakthroughs. It's coming up soon to about a year since I had the vision of oneness several times. But practicing the continuity practice, actually, is about how it happened. And I haven't had it since. So you have these high points, but it doesn't seem to, you know, carry over to maintaining that. It's very, very odd, very frustrating, for sure. Spiritual path can be very frustrating. Instead, you end up sick. Yeah, what is that? What is that? I don't have a sickness problem. I have a continuity problem. Continuity problem is the only problem I have. Sickness problem doesn't exist. Has absolutely zero. The sickness problem has no value whatsoever for me. None. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. So, see the vision of oneness, you need to see everyone as a son of God. And this is a gender-neutral term. It's S-U-N. Pardon the interruption. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. Now, it's tough when you get sick. You feel like giving up, right? You think, wow, this is terrible. How come I'm not having better, more success? And it is tough, for sure. You just have to keep plodding along. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. So there's these little techniques we can use, the continuity practice, this little statement that helps center us. I do not have a sickness problem. I do not have a situational problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a situational problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a circumstantial problem. I have a continuity problem. This is, then we don't take it seriously, circumstantial situation. That means it helps us wake up from the dream. Now, I was going to say, the vision of oneness, before I was interrupted, is what you see, is you see everyone as a Son of God. And again, son, S-U-N, is gender neutral, right? So we don't get hung up on that. It means S-U-N, where it's radiating in all directions. And everyone, all, this is the true identity of all. There's no gender to that whatsoever, the Son of God. No gender. And all sons of God, all radiating joy and love, freedom, peace, gratitude. Recognize that what we see as bodies and people and stuff is just a dream with no consequence to what anyone is whatsoever. No consequence. Therefore, it can be overlooked right now, can it? We do not have to take another moment's notice of the dream to see what the dynamics of the dream are, to see what effects, dynamics of the dream, consequences of situations that the dream persona is going to be put in. That is completely irrelevant to what everyone already is, what everyone is right now. So the vision of oneness is always right now. There's a wow, again, full stop in the wow. This is another technique, right? Full stop in the wow. Now this morning, I couldn't breathe at all, like a deep breath, because I would start coughing and hacking and would get all disjointed, and it was terrible. Now I can breathe, you know, freely just by using my spiritual will. So I don't have a sickness problem. I have a continuity problem. Full stop in the wow of, my gosh, vision of oneness. Now we see what it is. This dream has absolutely no consequence for what everyone is. None. Zero. So we're free to leave this vicinity of this dream. We can even dream the dream of supernature, death-free realm, the real world, in which no consequences or situations are arising for anyone, for any situation, you know, any situation is arising. No, everything's perfect, everything's fine. Because we don't need to follow this dream to find out, well, what happened to everybody. Nothing happens to anyone in this dream. Who gets saved and who doesn't? Who are the bad guys? Who are the, you know, the good guys, the bad guys? Who gets thrown into lake of fire? Who's the Antichrist? Who's the, all of that is totally irrelevant, because none of it has any consequence to what everyone is, which is this Son of God. No one needs to do anything to realize that, except to realize they don't need to do anything to realize it. No one needs to do anything to realize it. There's no one who has to do anything. Time does not have to pass in order for this to be true, that everyone is. What is? It's not like someone can get it, but someone else, they're still working on it. They still have to work on it. No. There's no work at all that has to be done on it, actually. Now, we have a continuity fear, so practically, this is the only problem we have. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. I don't have any other problem, actually. That is true. If the vision of oneness remains elusive, then we're doing something wrong. I mean, we're trying to do something, actually, instead of nothing. Say, well, I think that's someone they need to, you know, do something. Again, there's nothing that can affect what we are. So how can doing anything positive or negative affect what we are? It cannot. So then how can anyone need to do something? It cannot. There's no such need. Now Jesus calls his grievances, and we think, well, somebody has to do something. You know, I feel like they should have to do something. If Jesus says, hey, whatever grievances you hold to others, you hold to yourself. So if you think someone else must do something to be what is, you think you will have to also do that. So Jesus says, if we're not experiencing being a son of God, radiant joy, we're holding grievances, he says. For sure, we're holding grievances, which is what? Holding time. Of course, we're holding time, meaning something has to happen first. And then we'll be what we are. And so we think something has to happen for us too. Whatever time we hold others to, we hold ourselves to. Give unto others as you would have given unto yourself. Give unto others as you would give unto yourself. If you give time to others, you give time to yourself. Saying, you need time, then I think, well, I need time too, because we're all one. We're all exactly the same. We're all equal sons of God. So Jesus says, give up all grievances. Or Yeshua. Yeshua or Yeshua. I don't know. It's just truth says. Reason tells us, right? Reason tells us. Jesus just points out the reason within us. He says, oh yeah, right. How can I believe that all is one, is the eternal isness, if I believe that some aspect of that eternal isness that needs to do something to be that way? If I believe that, I believe that I have to also. We're all bound by it, then. I believe we're all bound by it. So we're getting close here to the vision of oneness. I just have to full stop in the wow. Just say, okay, wow, this I'm seeing this now. So at some point, acknowledge the progress you've made. This, then you feel the wow. This is a problem I find with people throughout my life. I found this is the main problem is, they can get into just nonstop, okay, I got this, okay, I got this, okay, and they never take the time to say, hey, wait a minute, let me look at the progress I've made. Wow. I mean, here we are, we just recognize we don't need time. We just recognize the grievances, the whole thing that Jesus has been saying. If we're not experiencing the joy of a son of God, it's because of grievances. If we hold someone else to that, we hold ourselves to it, meaning they have to do something. We're just laying it bare. I mean, this is like incredible progress. It's credible. It's credibly amazing. It's fantastic. It's wondrous progress, actually. Wondrous clarity. And so you take the time to acknowledge that. This is what I find that we struggle with. The continuity fear freezes us up, and we don't take the time to full stop in the now. Hey, just full stop in the wow of this progress I'm making. Acknowledge your progress. Take the time to acknowledge the greatness of your progress, because it is great. can work on containing that, getting familiar with it, feeling like this is my home. This is my home now. This closeness to seeing through grievances, recognizing this is where I live now. This is my home. So I have access, easy access to all this clarity here, because this is my home now. Your home, obviously, is a place where you have easy access to everything, right? You should, except maybe in the garage. But so this is our home, meaning easy access. Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah. Grievances, I can look at that carefully. Not a problem. Whatever you think others need to do, you'll think you need to do also. And the mistake people make is they think, okay, I don't need any time to be what I am, so I should be what I am right now. But we are already. But the continuity problem has us take time, honoring time. We honor time. We have to understand this, that it's wrong. It's that we're honoring time. We're choosing to continue to honor time. That's why we seemingly fail. Doesn't mean that means there's no Son of God there. There's no radiant sphere of joy there. I don't have it. No, we do. But the continuity fear means we're honoring time. We're so used to thinking we need to do something to be what we are. We need to make an adjustment that we keep honoring time. And so we're not, which is a grievance, really. So, anyway, those who try to just push through, plow through, bulldoze through, they don't take the time to stop, full stop in the wow, full stop in the wow. And realize this is where I live now. This is where I live, and just get accepted. They'll keep pushing. They say, okay, I got that. Now what's next? Okay, I got that. What's next? And they get overloaded. The continuity fear overloads them. And they end up then getting very argumentative and headstrong like an elephant. Become like a headstrong elephant. Get frustrated. Frustration shows up because they say, I'm smart enough. I should be able to get it. Continuity fear. If you're really smart, you'll recognize the continuity fear and do full stop in the wow. That's if you're really smart. If you don't do that, you're not really smart. you're not recognizing the difficulty for what it is, and not dealing with it, you know, appropriately. So what I'm seeing now is that the vision of oneness is easy to enter into. I mean, we should be able to do it. There's no reason not to. Time does not stand in the way at all. There's nothing that stands in the way. There's nothing that stands in the way. There never will be anything that stands in the way. Full stop in the wow. So I know turning the corner into 215 is difficult. Probably a lot of you are having difficulty. I certainly have been having difficulty. There's no question about it. You can feel that it's going to get real nasty, right? We sort of feel like, the pressure is now different level, right? But we have the tools. We've devised the tools here to succeed. We've devised the tools to succeed. Well, no guru's shown up yet. That's fine. If they don't want to show up, that's fine. I cannot force any gurus to show up. Because they're free to do whatever they want to do, right? Maybe they don't want to. We still have the tools. We still have the tools. See? Remember, marketing life and death is the exact same problem. It's just one problem. Of belief in that we're bound. We're not free. Longchenpa said, samsara and nirvana arising in the exact same spaciousness, subsiding in the exact same spaciousness. There's no difference at all, really. The marketing of life and the marketing of death are equally marketing nothing at all. There's nothing we can be sold on. We already are what we are. We don't need to sell ourselves on anything. There is no such thing for us to be sold on. We're absolutely free. So for us, there isn't thingness, so to speak. That's not how we experience. There can be all sorts of appearances, but it's not things. It's not bound by process or dynamics or the form. It's not designed, not bound by anything, because we're completely free to experience something different. We're totally sovereign over all appearances and experiencing. Totally sovereign. There's nothing that we need to have in order to be sovereign or to keep our sovereignty. No needs at all. It's weird though, in my life, just going around every day, is not much is showing up. It's like, huh, wow, amazing. Sometimes this little stuff shows up and you think, you know, we're told that when we make real progress that the world reflects that in some way. I don't know what it's reflecting. This is what a real teacher holds us to. Only the vision of oneness has value to me and just holds us to that. This is what is helpful, actually. Now, it's not easy because unless you're literally seeing the vision of oneness, you will then feel split to follow some dynamics of the dream. And it's tough to hold everybody to it, whereas a real guru, an actual guru, teacher, savior, can hold everyone just to this vision of oneness. Says, that's it. That's the only value you need. That's it. And just keeps holding everybody to that. Because they can see, literally see, this is so. They literally see it. They're not just thinking it. They're not just thinking it. They're not just conceptualizing it. They're not just, this is not theory. This is literally, they're seeing it. They're experiencing it. It's totally obvious to them. Totally apparent every moment. So holding us to vision of oneness. This is what's helpful. This is what's helpful. This is why I say this is what the world needs. And the world needs as many as possible in this, to hold everyone to this vision of oneness right now. The real vision of oneness, that is, nothing in this world has the slightest consequence or importance, relevancy at all to the vision of oneness, to what we are. Doesn't matter what happens. It's not like we need to become one. That is dualistic delusion to the max. We All is one right now, and always is. There's no way it can be otherwise. All share the exact same freedom. The exact same freedom from any notion of bondage whatsoever, not bound to, not forced to change, not forced to not change, whatever they're experiencing. This is true right now. So it's not about trying to make the world one, trying to develop, you know, more tolerance and diversity. Oh, that's the dream. That's total. That's how we stay asleep, because we keep thinking, oh, we're working on very important stuff in the dream. We have to keep dreaming. That is the delusion. We're not working on anything important in the dream. It's totally unnecessary. The dream is totally unnecessary. It has zero consequence. Absolutely no consequence whatsoever. So what we need is many, many, many in this world saying this, repeat, you know, conveying this to as many as possible. And if just one is conveying, most people will say, I don't know. If there's many, they might say, hey, you know, maybe there's just something to it. We tend to be that way we just think, we automatically assume only one person is saying, well, only one of us is saying this, that it probably can't be right because no one else is. But many are, we automatically assume, well, that's probably right because many are saying it. It's certainly, that is certainly one of our downfalls, isn't it? And we might say, well, it doesn't matter. If it's true, it's true. That's true, it doesn't matter. But the peer pressure of this world, and just, you know, the thinking like, I don't want to leave the pack, you know, I don't want to be an outcast. You think, I don't know. Full stop in the wow. As I say, be humble, be meek, unassuming. Spend some time just saying, okay, wow, this is really heavy. And the show-offs both will say, it's not heavy. Come on, do more, do more, do more. They always want to, you know, one-up gamesmanship, spiritual gamesmanship, one-up, 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 one, you know, just, I'm higher than everyone. I'm higher. That's the rabbit. Aesop's fable, that's the rabbit. The tortoise wins. The tortoise says, hey, you know, this is hard work, but I'm getting somewhere. I'm going to just kind of rest here for a second, get used to where I am. Carries us home with it. Be meek and humble and unassuming, and say, okay, I just made. Now you can be a diva actress and say, think, oh, okay, I can be higher than everybody by just stopping constantly. Oh wow, I just got to stop there. Oh wow, I just got to stop there. This is again trying to is gamesmanship, also passive aggressive gamesmanship, however you want to put it, where you go in the opposite direction, trying to impress the teacher. Oh, the teacher wants me to stop in the wow. Okay, great. Oh, I gotta stop right now. I gotta stop right now. I was thinking about this. Oh, I gotta stop. You know, and you know, it's just no, you know, trying to. That's ego. That's ego. So you want to push and push and push and push and keep going, going, going until, you know, it's just like you feel this is very intense. So maybe let me take a little break. That kind of feeling. We're not trying to prove anything on the path about how great we are on the path. We're only trying to wake up and see the vision of oneness. That's it. So everyone has to be very honest on their own path as to, you know, how can they go as fast as possible without going too fast. Yeah, going into 215. I started to do this detox diet. And that's possible part of the problem too, is maybe detox too fast can bring up some health problems. Mostly drinking juice, smoothies, blending. This one is orange, tangerine, half a lemon, banana, and grand pomegranate juice. Doesn't taste that great. The lemon on lime juice too. Trying to get a lot of lemon and lime right now. So there's no question that the stress is, and maybe a lot of people are eating a lot, they're nervous and stuff, and trying to turn that around and detox your system is a good idea. Is a good idea for sure. I'm trying to stay with it now. Give the body a rest. Don't keep stuffing food into it. That wears you out. Eventually you can have problems. Remember, I don't have a food problem. I have a continuity problem. Food problem has absolutely no meaning to me, no value to me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Today I drop all grievances and realize I am a son of God. Today I drop all grievances and realize all are sons of God. Today I drop all grievances and realize that all are sons of God. Today I drop all grievances and realize all are sons of God. Not sons of God in the making, not sons of God developing, not sons of God healing, not sons of God potentially. No, all are sons of God right now. Perfect. All are perfect sons of God right now. I drop all grievances and realize and see that all are perfect sons of God right now and eternally. I drop all grievances and see that all are sons of God eternally. There you go. I drop all grievances right now and see that all are sons of God eternally. I drop all grievances and see that right now all are sons of God eternally. I drop all grievances, I drop all time. 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 I free everyone from time. I free everyone from time. I see everyone as free from time. I see all as free from time. Right now, I see all as free from time. So we're still doing the best we can here. Hasn't been any big breakthrough. So what can you do? You keep working. It's like a diet. You don't reach it in one day necessarily. You know, so I just keep working on it. Keep working on it, and one day I'll say, hey, I'm a lot better shape than I was before. So it's very helpful to bounce back from this as we turn the corner. What we're doing is we're in the second half of the first half. We're in the second quarter of the tribulation period, in my opinion. Second quarter now. This is when we start to realize we're in the tribulation period. It dawns on us. Like, uh-oh, we're getting close to the midway point. And the midway point is, uh-oh. And after that, oh my God. So the pressure's on us. We realize, wow. And we tend to start having troubles. A definitely reached a point where I realized I was having troubles and not sure if I could bounce back. I said, I don't know if I can do it this time. I really is feeling like giving up and just saying, let's just go to see. What the heck, doesn't matter anyway, you know? So just give up, whatever. And then something, I don't know what it was, just use my will to say, no, I'm going to keep trying here. It's been very tough. So, but that's what we need to do. We just need to keep working, keep trying. Vision of oneness is there. The sonship of what we are is there, is in everyone. It's like, doesn't matter how dark the clouds are in this world, right? The sun is the same, still shining just the same as before. So imagine all these little suns around this big sun, and there's all these dense clouds around a little sun. Does that mean that the big sun is not shining on that just the same as it's shining on all others? No, it's still shining. This is the very same. And the little sun is shining, but the clouds may be preventing the big sun from feeling that in return shining, you know, but it's shining also. So we can't lose. It's impossible to lose. There's a loss. Losing is impossible. We cannot fail. Failure is completely impossible. But I would say, stay away from the news, as I've been saying for quite some time now. Stay away from the news as much as possible. And hopefully I'm going to stay away from YouTube, all the conspiracy videos on YouTube, which there are just millions. That doesn't help you awaken from the dream. It really doesn't. Just there isn't any momentum being generated at all. What we need to do is let free all from grievances and realize what everyone is right now. And don't take this grievances seriously. Don't take it, the belief that we only have potential. Don't take any of that seriously, that somehow the potential has to be developed. That's total lie. That's total nonsense. That's completely silly. We are created perfect and immaculate and absolutely free and sovereign from the get-go, from the very beginning of our creation. That's what we are. And remain that always. So we don't need the dream. We don't need to follow, you know, how are we growing? How are we grow? How are we evolving? How are we evolving as human beings? That's the funniest thing ever. don't forget to laugh at that. That's hilarious. How are we evolving as human beings? And now, as far as additional safeguards, I'm not sure. I have noticed that on watching sporting events on television, the corporate advertising is getting, it's just getting off too severe. The trailers from movies, everything, it's just subjecting yourself to an intense brainwashing by viewing any of those commercials and the attitudes of everybody. So I don't know if it's you know, how careful you need to be, exactly what the best move situation is, but hopefully, you know, I hope I can be very clear about it here, super, super soon. I believe people are generating all these addictions to grievances. They have intense addictions to grievances. If you're paying any attention to the world, it fosters grievances. It tells you these are the grievances that are acceptable. You know, be angry at these people and these people and these people. Those are grievances. If we literally saw that all are perfect sons of God, right now, without any possibility of being otherwise, how could we have grievances? We could not. So is there anyone that is not like that? No, not even one. Now people think they can just go to entertainments and that'll solve their problems for them, give a break from all the grievances. Now only seeing the truth, seeing the vision of oneness cures us, is the cure really. Only that has value. So we have to make that our goal, for sure. So realizing I can see, literally see, we're all sons of God. Literally see it. Not just think it, see it. Spiritually see it, that this is a fact. This is the goal of the spiritual path. So it bears repeating a million times, doesn't it? And a million times more. And so we don't get off track. It's easy to get off track right now. Easy. You don't want to get off track right now. Do not want to get off track. I sort of got off track a little bit here. I was reading books. I read a book about 2019 and the tribulation and the end times. And it was interesting, but there was nothing about the vision of oneness there. There was nothing about all these techniques we need to help us. Nothing at all. And basically it ended like saying, after the pole shift and everyone's wiped out, and if we're fortunate enough to survive, we'll be able to then work on establishing a new world, and that will be the golden age is this new planet, a new world based on a reconfiguration of latitude and longitude and change in land masses, some sinking, some rising, and just to be able to work on fashioning, putting the world back together again. That's supposedly the big prize, that a lot of people hold out. Yeah, that's what we're waiting for, to pick up the pieces and clean up all the damage and re-engineer the world, in a better way. And this, everyone thinks, this is what God wants, this is the ultimate. So they're eager for that. And this is, just ridiculous. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit as God created me. We're all sons of God. We're not bound by some planet. Having to, clean up all the toxic waste and devastated landscapes and try to build some new log cabins and some roads and think, wow, we're pioneering a new experience here in this world. Isn't this awesome? And we'll try to be more loving and kind to one another and stuff. This is the dream. This is a dream. All sorts of stuff happens in a dream, doesn't it? You have dreams at night, all sorts of crazy stuff's happening. Well, that's the universe. All sorts of crazy stuff happens. So vision of oneness, that's our goal. I don't have any pole shift problem, I have a continuity problem. Pole shift problem has no value for me, only the vision of oneness has value for me. Demand what your value is. The value is, vision of oneness is the only value there is for me. Nothing else has value. Which is true. Nothing else, everything else is just a grievance. Has no value because it's not true. Time is not true. Time, space, process, form, none of it's true. It's all a dream. Only the vision of oneness has value. Only the vision of oneness has value. So, day by day, try to steady yourself here. Maybe it's really difficult. Probably. It could be. It could be at this time, for sure. And I'm experiencing difficulties right now myself, but bouncing back here. All right, bounce back and don't give up. Keep working on it. If you won't have tomorrow if you give up today, so keep working at this. Help is on the way. All right, very great. That's it.